Sunday, November 17th, was a very special night at Mohegan Sun Arena. A concert for recovery featuring Keith Urban, powered by CT Realtors, brought together thousands of people to help shine a light on the opioid crisis in Connecticut and to fight the stigma associated with it. For a family from New Milford, it was so much more than just a fun night out. Maddie Morrissey has a new prized possession.
To Maddie, love Keith Urban.
A concert-used guitar from country superstar Keith Urban, given to the 12-year-old during a crowd-capturing moment that meant so much more to the Morrissey family.
Wait right there.
Urban noticed Maddie in the crowd, holding up a picture of her brother.
He was always there for me.
Brian Cody was 20 years old when he died on August 10th from an opioid overdose.
He was a mama's boy.
After a nearly three-year battle through recovery and relapse.
We woke up Christmas morning about 3 years ago and were told that Brian overdosed, but they were able to utilize Narcan, thank God. It's been a rough journey for us.
Tracy and Tony Morrissey say his death shook their entire family.
You know.
About a month after Brian died, the Morrisseys learned about a concert for recovery with Keith Urban, powered by CT Realtors.
One very special night, Mohegan Sun Arena.
Tony immediately looked into getting tickets, not because they're big Keith Urban fans, but because of the mission behind the show.
An awareness event to combat the opioid crisis in Connecticut.
Every dollar spent is going to actually help lots of folks. That kind of gave us some hope. Gave us something to look forward to, gave us a smile, a sense of, you know, comfort.
A kind of comfort that the whole family needed.
Not just her and I, but the whole family. We brought the Morrissey bunch, and then some.
The Morrisseys got tickets for the floor, armed with a picture of Brian and a feeling that something special would happen that night.
We were trying to get the photo of our son signed.
So you got a pin out behind the door.
That surreal moment became more than the Morrisseys ever could have imagined.
He told us to wait there, and then we turned around to the stage and he gave us the guitar.
When she turned around and they had the guitar, I was like, I just felt like, this is for you, Brian.
The guitar aside, you know, that moment when Maddie and I turned around, or you know, and she hoisted that guitar, and the love that came out of that place, and that just that moment there, that was just so special.
It was the kind of love Tony and Tracy and their kids say they needed.
Mr. Urban, thank you so much. I mean, that was just incredible what he did for my family that night. You know, we went there for hope and comfort. And that was just, we got more than that. And for that, I thank, you know, the Connecticut Realtors and all the folks that put that together. What a great, you know, idea that was to pull people together. And what you did was give us hope.
A hope symbolized by an unexpected gift.
That was like a dream.
A hope shared with others.
You're not alone. Like, there's other people out there dealing with it. There's help.
And a belief that Brian's story doesn't end with an overdose.
We actually have two choices, right? We can mourn a loss, or we can celebrate a life and make a legacy that will live on.
The Morrisseys are committed to now helping other families struggling with opioid addiction. The Concert for Recovery raised more than $600,000, which will now go to programs and organizations working to address all aspects of the opioid crisis here in Connecticut through a grant program administered by the CT Realtors Foundation. To learn more, go to ctrecovers.com.